Hello and welcome to Chairside Live. I'm your host, Megan Strong. In today's show, Dr. Chi is placing his first implant. He's placing a Hahn implant in a edentulous site number 30. He's following through the straightforward protocol of the Hahn surgical kit and then the final delivery of a BruxZir Anterior screw retained crown. Dr. Chi, it's all yours.
Thank you, Megan. For this case of the week, I'll take you through the clinical procedure of the placement and restorative process for my first implant case that I introduced in episode 213. My patient is a healthy 38-year-old female that had her lower right first molar, number 30, extracted in 2008 and restored with a fixed partial denture from 29 to 31. A few years later, she was convinced to remove the pontic and attempt shifting the second and third molars mesially with Invisalign to close the space. After only 2 months, she stopped the orthodontic treatment in favor of an implant in the future. The old abutment crowns on 29 and 31 were replaced by Dr. Abai with these beautiful BruxZir anterior restorations. Despite the mesial drift of the second and third molars, Dr. Abai was able to create enough space and a proper path of insertion for our future crown. Intraoral and radiographic examination allows us to determine the dimensions between the adjacent teeth and surrounding bone that will allow us to select which size implant we're able to place safely and predictably. Following a general guideline of establishing at least 1.5 millimeters between the implant and adjacent teeth, and 2 millimeters from the nerve, I select a Hahn 4.3 by 11.5 millimeter implant. A cone beam CT is an invaluable tool as we can get a three-dimensional digital visualization of the chosen implant within the edentulous space. After setting the planned position in the software, I have an estimated 3 millimeters or more between my implant and surrounding structures, safely within the recommended guidelines. Now on to the placement. After administration of local infiltrations, I create a mid-crestal, full-thickness flap so I can visualize the bone beneath. To reflect the soft tissue enough, I extend the incision to the mesial buccal and mid-lingual of number 29 and the distal buccal and mid-lingual of number 31. Once reflected, I begin the osteotomy with the first twist drill that's 1.5 millimeters in diameter, ensuring that I'm entering the bone parallel to the long axis of the adjacent teeth. The second twist drill in the sequence is 1.5 millimeters at the tip and increases in diameter to 2.4 millimeters near the coronal half to begin widening the osteotomy. With the parallel pin in place, I take a radiograph to verify that I'm in the correct position. Minor corrections to the angulation can be made using the subsequent shaping drills or a side cutting burr such as the Lindemann drill. Since no modifications need to be done, I move on to the 4.3 by 11.5 millimeter shaping drill in the Hahn surgical kit. Once the shaping drill has been placed to the proper depth, it's now time to place the implant within the osteotomy. I dial the handpiece speed down from 800 to 25 RPM to carefully position the implant slowly. Once fully seated and primary stability is achieved, I place a 3 millimeter healing abutment that allows the soft tissue to heal around it. Once the healing abutment is placed, I place a couple of interrupted chromic gut sutures to achieve primary closure of the flap. After 4 months of healing, it's time to take the impression for the final restoration. I remove the healing abutment and place a scan body since I will capture the impression digitally using 3M's True Definition Scanner. I apply a thin layer of contrast agent to the abutment and surrounding tissues for the scanner to acquire the intraoral information that's needed to fabricate this restoration. As I move the scanner around the area, I watch the screen as the system provides instant feedback while I capture the occlusal, buccal, and lingual surfaces. All digital impressions act like a digital triple tray, requiring a scan of the prep area, opposing dentition, and bite so the lab can establish the proper occlusion for the restoration. Once all the scans are completed for the digital impression, we'll then send this file over in our digital prescription to the laboratory. After a week of fabrication, we receive our screw-retained BruxZir anterior crown. Once the proximal contacts are evaluated and a complete seating is confirmed with a radiograph, I then torque the crown down to 35 Newton centimeters. To begin the bonding process, I'll place 3M Scotch Bond Universal and then light cure that for 10 seconds and restore the rest of the access hole with camouflage flowable composite. Since there's no apical mobility like with natural teeth, we want to adjust the occlusion until there is a shim stock drag and not a hold to avoid excessive occlusal force. The patient loved how the screw-retained BruxZir anterior crown provided a perfect blend with the adjacent restorations. To clarify, BruxZir anterior is a more translucent version of monolithic BruxZir, offering a high flexural strength of 650 megapascals. It's optimized for anterior applications, but is definitely strong enough for posterior indications if proper preparation guidelines are followed. If you haven't taken the steps into implants yet, I'm confident with the right training and usage of an easy system like the Hahn system, you'll be able to provide your patients with this treatment modality in the future. Thank you for tuning in to watch my journey through my first complete implant case. We'll see you on the next episode. Back to you, Megan.
Thank you for that, Dr. Chi. And if you'd like to see the first part of this case, you can watch episode 213 of Chairside Live. To do that, you can head over to chairsidelive.com or find us on YouTube or iTunes and watch that first part of the episode to get the whole experience of placing that first implant. Well, that about wraps it up for this episode of Chairside Live. On behalf of everyone here at Gladwell Laboratories, thank you for watching, and I'll meet you right back here next time.